make some fish goujons with tartare sauce from my new book, Nourish and Glow, the 10-Day Plan. This is a really simple recipe. I used to think that this type of recipe was really complicated, but actually it couldn't be more simple. Not everyone needs to be gluten-free, but if you are trying to cut back on eating too much gluten or too much bread, I wanted to create a really nice crispy crunch, the type of crunch that you would get on fish fingers, using some oats. So I'm just gonna pop those in a blender. And to give them some nice flavour, I'm just adding lemon zest, which really brings out the flavour in the fish. We know that fish and lemon goes beautifully together. And then I'm gonna add a little bit of pepper, quarter of a teaspoon of turmeric, and this gives it that lovely golden colour and a great flavour. And then lastly, I've got some cayenne pepper. It gives just a little kick. So you're just gonna whiz it up so that it becomes like a fine flour, but with a little bit of crunch. That's about perfect. And so I'm just gonna pour that into the dish. And then in order to make the crumbs stick to the fish, I'm just gonna use one egg, a little whisk. And then I've got some cod here, but you can pretty much use any white fish. You just wanna get something that's quite chunky. And I'm just gonna cut it into nice fish finger-like portions. My friends tell me that their children love this recipe. It's a good one for all of the family. And so it's a little bit messy, but you could probably get little ones if you have them to do this. It's quite fun. You just want to make sure that it's nicely coated in that egg and then dip it into the crumb. You want to make sure that the tray is nicely oiled, and then we're going to bake these in the oven for about 15 minutes. So they go nice and golden. I love this coating because it's such a versatile coating. You could wrap it on chicken or on vegetables. It's just great. Who would have thought that porridge oats would create such a lovely crunchy crust? And that's those done. And I'm just gonna give my hands a quick wash. Give a nice drizzle of oil, and then I'm just gonna pop these into the oven for about 10 minutes and then turn them over and give them another 3 or 4 minutes on the other side. So while they're cooking, I'm gonna make a quick tartare sauce. This wonderful invention, coconut yogurt. It's actually just the flesh of coconut creamed up together, but it makes a delicious and really creamy base for lots of dishes. So traditional for tartare sauce, I'm gonna be using just a teaspoon of capers to give it that nice zing. And as always, my favorite, some lemon zest, and then the juice of this lemon. And then I'm gonna put in half a shallot. Roughly chopped, because I'm going to blend all of this up. A nice, good bunch of parsley. Whiz it up, but you don't want to make it too fine. You want to keep it a bit chunky. And that is perfect. Oh, it smells incredible. And that's the tartare sauce made. Pretty simple. So this is my dairy-free version of a yummy tartare sauce. So these have been in for about 10 minutes. I'm just gonna quickly turn them over and do a few more minutes on the other side. And there you have it, my super easy fish goujons with a dairy-free tartare sauce. Perfect comfort food. So for more inspiration, don't forget to subscribe.